Professional firefighter and ITC instructor Andy Starnes joins us to talk about how thermal imaging is used in the fire service. We'll have that interview here in a moment, but first, the latest from ITC. We've got you covered from the air with SUAS thermal imaging classes available from ITC. Whether using aerial infrared for inspections or public safety, ITC has the right certification class for you. Head to infradtraining.com/schedule for more information on our SUAS Level 1 thermography or Level 1 public safety courses, including upcoming dates and locations. We hope to see you there. New for this year, the Infrared Training Center is now offering a Tactical Firefighting Thermal Imaging Level 1 certification course. The class, hosted by Insight Fire Training, is for firefighters and company officers who are using thermal imaging and would like to better interpret and incorporate thermal data into their decision-making process. Andy Starnes, Insight Fire Training's founder and instructor, is a 27-year veteran of the fire service and currently serves as a battalion chief for his local department in North Carolina. Recently, I had the chance to speak with Andy and ask him how thermal imaging is used in firefighting applications and what students can expect to learn from this new course. Here's what he had to say. So tell us more about your background. How long have you been a firefighter, and what was it that first called you to serve your community?
I've been in the fire service for a very long time. I'm only 44 years old, but I've been chasing my father around since I was 8. From the time I can earliest remember, I was waiting tables at fish fries and barbecues to help out with fundraisers. And my first monkey bars, if you will, was a 1978 American LaFrance fire truck. And I started officially volunteering as a junior firefighter in 1991, 92, and became a career firefighter in my current employer in 98. Been an amazing journey. I believe it's a calling, not a job. I mean, I'm thankful that they provide me a paycheck to take care of my family, but it's been a wonderful, wonderful journey.
So how is thermal imaging used in firefighting applications? What benefits does it provide?
It was traditionally used as search and overhaul, searching for victims, searching for downed firefighters, and looking for hidden fire. That was the extent of it until the late 90s, early 2000s, so a lot of people wrote about things called tactical thermal imaging or tactical tick use, and that's when NIST and some other people who were way smarter than me came up with the concept of using the tick to look for things such as, hey, not only can we do that, we can also find the fire first through our size up. We can also locate the victim 70% faster than we can without a thermal imaging camera. We can see unseen hazards that may harm us, like holes in the floor and other things that are not traditionally taught. But we focus strictly on the fire ground in our training.
So maybe expand on that. What type of training do you offer at Insight?
We break down our course into sections. The way it works is first we teach them the why, as a wise firefighter Aaron Field says, you can't apply if you don't know why. So we teach them why it's important first, because a lot of firefighters would view this information almost as, why are you trying to tell me to look at it differently? And we don't take away their fundamentals, we enhance it. So we start with the why and we teach them about heat, you know, thermal severity, how it applies to them. And most importantly, how they can apply that in their day-to-day activities, because if they can't apply it, they're not going to listen to you. Then we go into key attributes of thermal imaging, how the camera sees its world around them from field of view to temperature modes, application modes, resolution, distance to spot ratio, emissivity, things that I was never taught about. I was simply taught, turn the camera on, read the little number in the bottom right-hand corner. And that was it. Now we teach them that, and we teach them the things that can hurt them, the contraindications and the limitations of the camera, and some of the things I was taught that a camera couldn't do.
And so is that the curriculum that we're going to have in the new Tactical Firefighting Thermal Imaging Level 1 that we're working together with you on?
Yes, sir. It's a lot more in-depth than what we're allowed to do in most fire departments, because most fire departments, as you've learned, have a lot of, they either have budget or time constraints or both. So a lot of times they want you to deliver a 40-hour course in 8 hours. So each fire department's been getting little pieces of this curriculum, and very few have taken on the whole gamut. So day one would consist of a full 8 hours of the why, the key attributes, the contraindications, and understanding and interpreting the data correctly. Day two begins with breaking into the application. Each day is a portion of the things that they already do on the fire ground, but we take building science, thermography-based concepts that ITC has taught, and we translate it to the fire ground. Like, how does a building inspector inspect a building? Okay, well, how does a firefighter size up a building looking for where the fire is, where it's going? We teach them those concepts. We talk about communication. We talk about situational awareness. And then the last day is a full day focusing on searching for the victim, searching for fire, and searching for their lost brothers or sisters that may be down. So we're working on helping firefighters be more, we call, more intelligently aggressive.
To learn more about our new Tactical Firefighting Thermal Imaging class that we're offering with Insight, head to infradtraining.com, where you'll find the full course description, as well as upcoming dates and locations. It's important to note the class is also offered as an on-site option too. Of course, the best way to stay in touch is to join us online and get social with ITC. We're on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and LinkedIn, where you'll find the latest industry news, valuable tips, special training offers, and a whole lot more. And if you're looking for our complete training schedule, or perhaps just want to register for an upcoming certification course, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or check out our website at infradtraining.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you online again soon.